training shoes that you put are so heavy.
That's what
it was. Either wear these things that are like yours now, your spikes now, or wear much heavier than that. Just have shoes twice as heavy.
Yeah.
So it was like, so I wear the spikes, and I had, I must have had a 2 lap lead. I was double lap after about 4 miles, and I never wanted to drop out so much on my life. And I'm learning, you can't jump out when you're first. You know, it's just like, I was forced to go those last 2 miles. I wanted to walk so big. I can't imagine what I looked like. I was down to 6 minutes.
Wow. And you're still running.
Yeah, well, it was another super hot day. Me was a mom with the university. That was bad. I remember coming home and my parents wanted me to go to church. And I can remember lying down across the bed, just falling asleep. My running stuff. I went actually breast plant across the bed, not even like the right bed.
Yeah, I've done that.
Fell asleep.
You know what's even worse? Do you know Josh Cox, like the marathon culture guy? He did 31.2 on the track.
I do own one of them.
What?
The 100-mile relay. 100 people running 1 mile. We set the Guinness World Record.
Wow. Did I tell you,
like about 30 years ago?
Who ran in it? Like just all
members of the Sure Athletic Club. High school kids, college kids, all the people.
The guy, not the guy that I stayed with, one of the guys on the team at Johns Hopkins has the world record for the lunch mile. Where he has to touch the